I believe these were smuggled into the prison this morning by the social worker.
Barry Simmons?
That's right. He was processed by Meg Morris and he gave them to Paddy Lawson.
I fail to see how this is relevant to what we are discussing.
We are discussing lack of security.
Very well, point taken. This is serious. Lawson is due to be released.
Was due.
Your insubordination is not yet a closed subject, Miss Ferguson, so please do not correct me.
What do you want?
An excuse to stay in Wentworth?
Well, you're a bit late. Hazel's out.
Like I said, you'll do.
Back off or I'll clobber you.
Oh, yeah, look at me, I'm scared.
Lay off, you stinking bitch!
Do yourself a favour, Lawson. Make it quick.
No!
Oh, I'm sorry, Paddy, but I can't let those mongrels hold me now, can I? Where's Paddy?
Probably in her dorm.
No, just look there.
That poor kid probably want to be by herself for a bit. Maybe she's still in the loo.
What are you grinning at?
Nothing. Oh, leave me alone, will you?
I asked you a question.
Oh, what is this? Do I have to go around sour face like the rest of you no-hopers?
Don't you call me names, you smart alecky trollop.
Where's Nola?
How would I know?
Is she after Paddy?
She might be.
Damn. Oh, I'll come with you. She said you were going to the loo. I'll check there.
You go look yourself.
Paddy, you in there?
Premeditated. Looks like you're stuck with me now.
She was a pushover.
I wonder if she knew she was doing me a favour.
Latham gone?
Yes, and she's worried sick about her daughter. Bound her so far away, gives her sister-in-law the perfect excuse not to let the child visit.
Tough. If Latham is so concerned about motherhood, she should have given it a lot more thought before she wound up in here.
That still doesn't give the department the total right to ignore the women's basic... Oh,
tell it to the governor. She wants to see you anyway.
Meg, right. Lawson's been killed.
What?
We need the police ambulance quickly.
The governor knows. Oh,
you better come with me. Oh,
right. This your doing?
Yeah.
You're right, Smith.
Oh, sure. Everything's just great.
All right. Come on, McKenzie. Smith, come with us. You wait here. The police are on their way.
Come along, Smith.
Where the hell has been? She sends me on a wild goose chase looking for Paddy, and I don't know what's going on.
If you ask me, it's safer to stay out of anything B and Nola have got going.
Well, where's Chrissy? She promised me a game of cards.
Everything all right in here?
No. Where the hell is everyone? Where is Chrissy?
Chrissy's been transferred, Lizzie, to Barnhurst.
What? Oh, God, that's not fair. She didn't even say goodbye.
That's enough, Lizzie.
Well, what's going to happen about a little kid? She'll go off her head if she can't see her.
You know the rules. I can't discuss it with you.
Oh, this place has gone to the dogs. Nobody tells you anything anymore. Now, where are Bea and the others?
Now, that's enough, Lizzie. Now, just calm down.
Oh, God. Something going on in here. I can feel it in me bones.
She was lying there, dead. And McKenzie was standing over her.
And you attacked McKenzie?
Well, wouldn't you have?
Why, McKenzie?
I want to know what Lawson did that provoked such an unnecessary act.
Not a thing. It just seemed like a good idea at the time.
Don't insult my intelligence, McKenzie. We both know that Lawson gave me information about you. And I am not unfamiliar with the prisoner's code on lagging.
Yeah. Well, that was just a little bonus. I wasn't after Lawson. She just happened to be the first one who walked in.
Mm. A bitch!
That'll do, Smith.
Mrs. Powell, take Smith back to the others. She will have to make a statement to the police later.
Yeah, well, what about her?
If I will make the decision, Smith. You may go.
Come on.
In all my years as governor, I don't think I have ever come across anyone as cold-blooded as you are, McKenzie. You will be taken to solitary until the police arrive. And quite frankly, the longer you are kept away from the others, the better it will be for all of us. Miss Ferguson?
Come on, McKenzie. Sure, Miss Ferguson. Too bad I'd already packed my case to go back to WA. Now I don't reckon I'll be leaving here for a long time. What do you reckon?
Let's not have any trouble, huh?
About time, too. I've been in here all on my own.
Thanks very much.
Oh, you know what I mean. Then Mrs. M comes in and tells us that Chrissy's been shanghaied.
Daddy's dead.
No one tells me anything anymore. You clear out. Nola's disappeared. Paddy's gone.
Paddy's dead.
Oh, what are you on about?
She's dead. You hear me, Lizzie? Patty's dead.
Oh, God. No. Oh, poor little mate.
Was it?
Oh. She just walked into it in the shower, look.
Why, B? She'd already bashed her for lagging. Why, B? Why?
Oh, no reason. Except to save her own rotten neck. It could have been anyone. You, or Trixie, or even me. Oh, what's happening in here, me? What's happening?
Jeez, so she's really done it. Didn't think she'd have the guts.
What do you know about it if you're in that bitch's plan?
No, I'm not honest. Well, she told me if she killed someone here, they couldn't take her back to hang. She said Hazel was first choice, but Hazel's gone. I thought it was just talk. I didn't think she'd have the nerve to follow through.
Any idea what it must be like to have your lungs fill up with water until they burst?
No.
Well, she's pretty good with kids. But let's see how she goes when she's got her face up to me.
Sit down, Meg. Are you all right? You look a little pale.
I'm sorry. I just can't believe it. If only I'd gone to the shower block with her.
Oh, that's ridiculous, Meg. There's no reason why you should have accompanied her.
Wasn't there? I mean, we knew McKenzie had a grudge against Lawson.
It wouldn't have mattered who walked through that door. McKenzie was intent on killing someone to prolong her stay here. It could quite easily have been you.
Yes, it's a frightening thought.
McKenzie is a frightening woman. Has the ambulance been yet?
Yes, they've taken away the body. And I'll check through the files and notify the family.
Good. Oh, what about that young man from Woodridge?
Andy Hudson. Mm. I'll get in touch with his sister, if you like.
Thank you. Have the police questioned McKenzie?
Yes, and they're coming back tomorrow to see Smith.
Well, that's just about everything.
Not quite. Joan Ferguson said you wanted to see me.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Is there something wrong?
Yes, I'm afraid so. Before Lawson was killed, she was caught handing out contraband cigarettes to the women.
Contraband?
Yes. It appears they were brought into Wentworth by Barry Simmons.
I don't believe it.
Well, I'm afraid it's a fact. Miss Ferguson found them on Lawson after the interview.
Ferguson, I might have known she'd be at the bottom of this.
Well, it is a valid complaint. As you signed the man in, why weren't they discovered during a routine search?
Obviously, because I didn't search him.
But that is the point. He should have been searched.
Well, I'm sorry. I just didn't see the necessity. I mean, it's not as though we don't know him. And I've searched his briefcase every other time.
Unfortunately, Meg, this is the time it will appear on your record.
Geez, well, what do you know? Room service. Make the most of it.
I hope it chokes you.
Thanks for nothing. How do I know there's not poison in it or something?
You never know your luck.
You can take your chances. Either eat it or go hungry. Come on, Birdsworth.
Eat it up. Might clean your mouth up.
Detective Skinner and Gilbert.
Yes, of course. Mrs. Davidson's expecting you. I'm Mrs. Powell, the Deputy Governor. Would you sign in, please? I've organised an interview room for you. Who would you like to see first?
Let's start with McKenzie. She's really something else, isn't she?
Oh, yes, she certainly is. What about Smith?
We can get a statement from her later.
Right. Miss Ferguson, stay here until Heather arrives, will you?
Certainly, Mrs. Powell.
This way.
Hi, Miss Ferguson.
Good morning, sir.
Starting to think I should take up residence in this place. I see we've got another mess on our hands with this Lawson girl.
Of course, it's all so unnecessary.
No? What makes you say that?
Well, there was animosity between McKenzie and the Lawson girl. In my opinion, security wasn't strict enough. But I really shouldn't say any more. It's not my place. I'll let the governor know.
No, Miss Ferguson, please feel free. If I had a dozen officers like you, my job would be much easier.
Speaking of which, Sarah, there's something here that I think you should have a look at.
What, more trouble?
Let's say another breach of security involving an officer.
Meg Morris. Well, it's going to take me some time to read this properly.
Well, it may be some time before the governor can see you. Perhaps you'd like to go to the staff room. You'll have some privacy there.
Oh, yes, I'll do just that. Thank you.
Come on, Bee. You gotta eat something, love.
Oh, what's the point? I couldn't taste it anyway.
It's more than you can say for that bloody mongrel McKenzie. She's gonna taste hers, all right.
What have you been up to?
Just a quick dash of dishwashing liquid into her porridge. Should give it a lovely lemon flavour, don't you reckon?
Pity it wasn't cyanide.
No. Too quick.
You're right. I want something long and lingering for that bitch.
They don't seem to have much of an appetite. I can't say I blame them. All right, ladies, you can start clearing away. You've got 2 minutes.
I've got to go down the staff room to add a few points to our book, eh?
You just watch yourself. Good enough to contend to without the screws reducing their points to zero.
Now, let me just add a few at a time. Screws will never spot it. Got to be up early to catch me.
Oh, what's going on? You're asking me the same questions you did yesterday.
How long did you hold it down for?
I don't know. I wasn't timing it. Until the bubble stopped coming up. Then I knew she was dead.
You know you'll probably get life.
Sure. But it's better than death, isn't it? And they can't hang me whilst I'm in Wentworth, can they?
No.
And they can't send me back to WA until I finish serving my sentence here, right?
Technically, they can't. Look, I wouldn't look so happy if I were you, McKenzie. Hang's not the only way you can go, you know. Look at Lawson. You never know what's waiting around the next corner, do you?
He's right, McKenzie. You could end up wishing you had hanged. It might be quicker than what some of the women have planned for you.
Oh, I don't think so, Mrs. Powell. You see, I got my own personal bodyguard. You and the rest of the screws around here. You get paid to look out for me, and you're really going to earn your money from now on.
I can't understand why you're defending her. Look, the report is perfectly clear. The woman is guilty of negligence.
I am simply pointing out it was not Miss Ferguson's place to make out a report on the subject, and it most certainly was not her place to give it to you.
Well, thank God she did, because if I'd waited for somebody else to tell me, I might have waited weeks.
Ted, that is both unfair and untrue, and I take great exception to it.
What?
Suggesting that I would delay a report on Meg Morris.
I'm doing no such thing. I'm merely saying that Morris is a problem.
Not as far as I am concerned. She is a warm, understanding person, and this sometimes leads her to being a little indiscreet. That is all.
Precisely, and that is just my point. It is not an officer's job to be warm and understanding.
You can't mean that.
Erica, the department is only interested in seeing that the institutions run smoothly, Wentworth included. Now, Morris makes waves. She doesn't fit the mold. If she wants to work on an emotional level, okay, let her going back to being a probation officer. But I will not have her disrupting Wentworth.
In the past, she has given valuable years of service to the department.
I'm more interested in the future, Erica. And as far as I'm concerned, this place will function far more professionally without Meg Morris.
Please sit down, Meg. This is very awkward, and I don't really know where to start.
It's Ferguson again, isn't it?
Yes. She's caused us both a very big headache, and there's no easy solution.
Huh?
Well, Meg, I've known you far too long to beat about the bush. Ferguson has filed a report with Ted Douglas about your slip-up with Barry Simmons.
Oh, no. I gather he wasn't too pleased.
He was furious. He... Well, there's no other way to say this. He feels that it would be in Wentworth's best interest if you were dismissed.
You can't be serious.
I argued with him on the strongest possible level. I told him how much I valued you as an officer, but, well, you know how dogmatic he can be when he wants to.
I know exactly what you mean. You needn't say any more. I've been thinking about this for quite some time. I think it'd be best if I resigned. I'll leave as soon as it's convenient.
What are you doing here?
Just cleaning up, Mrs. Powell.
Yeah, well, you're taking your time about it.
Oh, it's me old bones. They don't work like they used to, but I've finished now.
All right, then. Get out.
Poor old Lizzie. I am going to miss her.
Meg, you can't be serious about leaving. What choice have I got?
Joan Ferguson is only going to think she's won. Oh, damn it, Meg, you can't. It's such a waste.
This place is so much a part of me now. But I have to go whilst it's still my decision to make. The worst part, of course, is knowing that everything will go on as usual without me.
No, it won't.
So I told them how McKenzie just stood there and looked like she'd won tats.
They didn't say nothing about me, did they?
Oh, why should they? Don't tell me you're feeling left out.
Why? I told you before, I just want a quiet life.
Great.
Let's just keep it that way.
Where the hell is Lizzie? She's taking her time.
She's gone down to the staff room. I hope the screws haven't copped her for fiddling that points book.
No way. There's 60 years of cunning up that sleeve.
Hey, listen, you lot. Guess what I just heard? Mrs. N's leaving.
We're going to have to get you a hearing aid, Lizzie.
It's true, I tell you. And it's all because of the freak. I heard him talking.
What, Mrs. M and Ferguson?
No, Poface and Mrs. M. Poface tried to get Mrs. M to reconsider because she said the freak had won. But Mrs. M said, no, she's got to go.
Jeez, she was the only one around here I liked.
We all do. Well, if that's true and she's leaving because of the freak, we'd better do something about it.
Like what?
Maybe it's about time Ferguson found out what does happen when a screw loses all her points.
Points? Oh, bugger it. I better get back to that board before the spook.
You going somewhere?
Yes. No. Well, I had to finish in the kitchen before I came back here, and I've just remembered I haven't finished.
I don't know about that. I'd say you are well and truly finished.
You look as though you've had your fill of Wentworth for the day. Or has Wentworth had its fill of you?
I suppose you must feel pretty proud of yourself. Do you always get your own way?
Most of the time. I'm a pretty poor loser.
Well, congratulations. This time you win. I'm leaving Wentworth. Does that make you happy?
Well, how on earth could she imagine these changes could go undetected?
Apparently, she planned to change the board in the recreation room to tally with the book.
Well, can we possibly adjust the points?
No, not a chance. Well, we don't know how many times Lizzie has played scorekeeper. The only solution is to start from scratch.
Oh, it's out of the question. You know how much trouble the women would cause. No, we'll just have to rethink the whole situation. Meanwhile, I'll have to decide what to do with Birdsworth.
Yeah. Well, look, Mrs. Davidson, it's about Meg Morris.
Yes, I know what you're going to say.
We can't afford to lose her. She's such a good officer.
I don't want to see her go any more than you do, but she has resigned. It is her choice, and we must respect it.
Choice? Oh, my God, she had no choice. You know it.
I do not want to discuss this any further.
Very well.
Now, you have a progress report on McKenzie for me?
Yeah, well, she's not showing any signs of remorse. She gave the police a full confession. I think she relished doing it. It seems her sole motive was to stay here in Wentworth.
She must realize the women won't allow her to get away with killing Lawson without planning some retribution.
The police appointed that out to her. She is relying upon us to see that it doesn't happen.
Well, that's all very well whilst she's in solitary, but we can't possibly appoint an officer as a bodyguard once she is returned to the women.
She seems to think we can. She's also aware that we can only keep her there legally for another day.
Yes. If only the isolation block were finished, the workmen say it'll be at least another 2 weeks. Well, Mackenzie needs protective custody, but I don't see how we can possibly give that to her unless she stays exactly where she is.
And then Davo reckons she's gonna stop me buy up for a week. No fags! God, I don't reckon my lungs will stand it.
Yeah, well, don't come to me. I've got no sympathy for you.
Yeah, be warned you not to go overboard with them points, but you wouldn't listen.
There you go. I was only trying to get the bloody telly back for us.
Oh, I know, love. Lord knows how long it'll be before we get one now. But what I'm interested in is what are the screws going to do about the points chart?
Do you reckon that we'll have to start all over from the beginning again?
Not if I can help it, we won't. Mrs. Morris, is it true what we hear? Are you going?
How did you know? Lizzie, you didn't.
Well, I can't help it if I've got extra sharp hearing.
Especially if her ear happens to be glued to the door.
But have you handed in your resignation? Now, you know the regulations.
Yeah, off by heart. Have you resigned?
All right. Yes, I did.
There, you see.
But you can't.
There's no way known we'll let you go. You know that, don't you?
I appreciate your concern, but you are out of line. It's my business, and it's done now.
Well, it will have to be undone. We should have some say in how we're treated and by who. And we'll damn well keep saying it until Mrs. Davidson takes that resignation of yours and sticks it where it belongs.
Yeah. Listen, get Lauren to put these through the machine, will you, honey? Hello, Mrs. Morris. You've been a stranger lately.
Thought I'd have some lunch with you.
Oh.
Needed a change of scenery.
Listen, Mrs. Morris, I heard a rumour on the grapevine. I don't like it very much. It concerns Patty.
Judy, I can't tell you anything. It's against regulations.
Well, couldn't you tell me at least not to listen to rumours?
Sorry, I can't do that either.
God. She was such a nice kid. What a waste. Well, come on through, please. Didn't you have something you were going to do, huh? Have a seat, Mrs. Morris. I'll make lunch in a minute. Would you mind putting the kettle on for me, love, please? Hey, you're looking a bit down. Did you have a lousy week, eh?
I've had a lousy few weeks.
Oh?
I've just resigned.
What? Mrs. Morris, you can't do that. You're the only friend those women have got.
I cannot fight Joan Ferguson anymore. I mean, she watches me all the time and uses every rule in the book to undermine me. Well, if I don't resign, the department's going to sack me anyway.
What the hell for?
Barry Simmons slipped a few cigarettes to Patty before she... Well, it is regulations to be searched, and I didn't do it.
I can't believe what's been happening at that place. Well, I suppose you could always come and work here when they put me back inside.
Have you heard anything more about that?
Yes, more's the pity. Tomorrow's the day of reckoning. I haven't even got a solicitor yet.
From my point of view, she hasn't got a leg to stand on. I mean, you should be suing her for fraud. Shouldn't be hard to prove that she's just after your father's money.
Oh, I don't know what to do. I mean, for a while there, I really wanted my family back, you know? Healing old wounds, all that stuff. But heck, I got a family here, a beautiful family, Laurie and the baby. I never cared about Francis. What's the point?
That is not the point. If Francis is vindictive enough to press charges, then you should do everything you can to defend yourself.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I think I'll make the tea.
Hey, Lizzie, what are you doing? That's bleach.
Oh, God. I can't think straight since poor little Patty copped it. She's gonna be out of here today. Oh, Maxie, I reckon this is the rottenest thing that's ever happened since I've been in here.
Oh, come on, Lizzie, it's too late to upset yourself. That Nola McKenzie's a flaming nutcase, I reckon.
Yeah, they should have sent her back to Perth. Hanging's just what she deserves.
No, hanging's too good for that bitch.
Oh, yeah. Well, what are you going to do about her anyway, B?
Wait and see.
You know, I saw this movie once about this guy on death row waiting to get the chop, and he was glad when they did it because he reckoned the waiting was worse than getting stretched.
Hmm. Maybe we can organise a death row of our own right here.
How do you mean? Make her think her number's up.
Well, it is if I get my hands on her.
Yeah, but how are we going to do it?
We can't poison her food. Screws soon get onto that, especially after I laced her brekkie this morning. So what are we going to do, B?
Well, hang on, I'm thinking. We'll start off by sending her a letter.
A letter?
Hmm. Her very own death certificate.
Hey, yeah, we could make it look proper by using the plates from the print shop.
Right. Has anyone got a pencil?
Oh, yeah, here. I snaffled these out of the staff room this morning.
Great.
Here it is, Lizzie.
Oh, there we go. And what I want you to do, Lizzie, is take this down to the print shop and give it to us ever on duty. Get them to print it up for us. Name of deceased... Nola McKenzie.
Give me a ring if there are any more. Hi.
Thanks.
Have a good lunch?
Oh, just some tea and sandwiches at the halfway house. Had to get away from this place for a while.
Have you thought any more about your resignation?
What is there to think about? I mean, it's either that or get the departmental boot from Douglas.
Come on, Meg, it's not as bad as that. Mrs. Davidson wants you to stay, so surely she can just talk to the department. It could be just a reprimand.
Well, get a slap on the wrist and then make out as though nothing ever happened? No thanks, Colleen. There are just too many restrictions now. I know we had to tighten things up after the fire, but I just can't work Joan's way.
But the restrictions are on the women, not us.
Are they? I can't even say good morning to Lizzie without looking over my shoulder to see if Joan's hearing. I mean, the only difference between them and us is that we get to go home of an evening, and even then we're searched. No, I'm sorry, I just can't stay.
Will you watch it, Lizzie? Who was in the workshop?
Babs. And she reckons it's a beaut idea, only they can't get it done today because Poface is standing over them. They have to get an order out.
Oh, well, we're in no hurry. Mackenzie's not going anywhere.
Saw Mrs. M in the corridor. I don't think she's changed her mind about leaving.
Why would she? She's as fed up with the freak as we are.
Well, that stinks, I reckon. Can't we do something to make her stay?
I was thinking of talking to Mrs. Davidson. She can't be too keen on Mrs. M leaving either.
All right, you lot, get back to work.
Right. I'd like to make a formal request to the governor, please, Miss Ferguson.
What about?
A personal matter.
I think the governor's far too busy to be bothered with you, Smith.
Is that right? Why don't you ask her?
Watch it, Smith, or you'll be on a charge.
Well, that's the only way I can get to see her, okay, but I did ask nicely.
You're a fool.
I'd love to discuss my state of mind with you, Miss Ferguson, but unfortunately, it's against regulations.
Come in. Sorry, I thought my secretary said Miss Bryant.
Yeah, well, I am Judy Bryant. I spoke to you on the phone.
But I...
Yeah, well, that was my sister. She was impersonating me. She's trying to buy some time because she wanted me to sign my father's will over to her.
Oh, please sit down, Miss Bryant.
Thanks.
This is quite serious. Have you spoken to the police about this?
Well, that's why I'm here. See, when I found out what she did, I got pretty angry and I thumped her. Now she's going to press assault charges against me. So I'm going to need some help. I'm doing court tomorrow.
Well, I'll be happy to represent you, but I think we should study your options. Seems to me that there are grounds for charges against her.
That's just what I wanted to hear. Why don't you go to her, and you say to her that if she drops the charges against me, then I won't press charges against her.
Well, it's certainly worth trying. Why don't you tell me all the details, Miss Bryant?
B. Smith, Governor.
Bring her in. Miss Ferguson tells me you have a personal problem, Smith.
We all do, Mrs. Davidson. Mrs. Morris's resignation.
That has nothing to do with the women. If an officer wishes to leave, she is perfectly at liberty to do so.
But that's the point. She doesn't want to leave, does she?
Did she tell you that?
How could she? She's not allowed to talk to us.
That is a long-standing rule, Smith, and all the officers must obey it.
Oh, come off it. It's a rule that's never enforced because it's unworkable and you know it. If the screws and the women are not allowed to communicate, how are you going to know what the problems are?
I do not wish to discuss it.
Mrs. Morris is the only screw who gives a damn about the women.
And it's her decision, no one else's.
Okay. We know who's responsible. We'll just take a few more points off the chart.
I thought we'd lost those ridiculous charts.
Oh, we have, several times. But they keep turning up like the proverbial bad penny. And we're all looking forward to what happens when the points fall to zero.
And what is supposed to happen then?
You know what happens when the women get out of hand. Riots. Fires.
Are you threatening me, Smith?
No. Not a threat. Just a friendly warning from one who knows.
This was supposed to be finished by lunchtime. If it's not done by this afternoon, you stay here till it is.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Sweet F.A. She reckons that if she wants to leave, there's nothing she can do about it. Gave her a scare, though. I told her I'd reduce the screw's points to zero.
Oh, come off it, B. We've got to do more than that.
Yeah. You know, I reckon we've been working too hard lately. About time we took a break. So where's up tomorrow morning? We're on strike.
Beauty!
We'll spread the word this evening. Tomorrow after brekkie, we all go down to the rec room, sit down nice and peaceful, and if the screws want any work done, well, then get their own hands dirty for a change.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't expect you so soon, Mr. Askin. Oh, Maureen, sorry. We've got a bit of business to talk about. Thanks, sir. Sit down.
Oh, thank you. I went straight over to see your sister after you left, Miss Bryant.
Any luck?
Well, yes and no. She's worried about us going to the police, but I couldn't convince her to drop the assault charge.
She must really hate my guts. It's too late for that anyway.
Well, we can always ask for a postponement to prepare our case.
What case? Let's just get it over with.
Look, if you'd only go to the police, they'd impound her passport and she couldn't leave the country.
No. Let's forget it, huh?
But we could use that in your defense. Now, you must know you could end up in jail again.
Yeah, I do know that. And I'll tell you one thing. If I end up in jail, I certainly don't want to spend it locked up with her. Let's just forget it, okay?
All right. The client always knows best.
What the hell are they up to? Come on, you lot! Master! Not here.
Must be in the rec room. It's the only place they have access to on this floor. Go and get some other officers.
Oh, come on, we can find out what's going on.
No, we don't know what they're up to. I'm not going to have anyone walking into a trap. Go and get the officers from the East Wing.
Good.
We should have laid in some tucker. I bet they won't feed us.
We've only just had breakfast. You're everlastingly thinking of your stomach.
Yeah, well, I'm just looking ahead, that's all. Mm. Here they come. A whole mob of them.
All right. What's going on?
We're on strike. What does it look like?
Don't be smart. Now get back to work, the lot of you.
Looks unanimous to me.
What do you want?
We're not allowed to discuss our grievances with officers, Mrs. Powell. You should know that.
Oh, don't play silly games with me, Smith.
We'll speak to no one but the governor.
Well, she's not in. She had to go to court.
We're in no rush.
Lock them in, Miss Ferguson. We're wasting our time.
Good morning, Miss Bryant. How are you?
Nervous.
Of course. I don't suppose you've changed your mind.
Mm. Good morning, Judy.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Davidson. This is Mrs. Davidson, the governor of Wentworth. Mr. Askin, he's representing me.
How do you do?
Good morning. From what Miss Bryant's told me, I understand the police might declare you a hostile witness.
Apparently so. But I'm here to say everything I can to help Judy, even though I'm appearing for the prosecution. I may have witnessed the assault, but in my opinion, it was justified.
I see that you get every chance to speak during cross-examination.
Yeah, we're going to need all the help we can get.
Now, stop that. We need positive thinking. Mm. Hello, Bill.
John. G'day, what are you doing here?
Well, the Bryant case, third on the list. Any idea what time we might expect to be heard?
Haven't you been notified? Mrs. Hunter was in my office at 9 o'clock this morning. She's not pressing charges.
You're kidding.
No. We're certainly not going ahead without her testimony. And right now, she's on a flight to New York. The case is dropped.
Thanks, Bill. I owe you a drink for that one.
My pleasure.
Judy, I am pleased.
Yes, so am I.
So you don't need me after all. Well, I'll see you later when the money comes through from America.
Thank you very much, Mr. Askin.
Pleasure. Mm. Goodbye, Mrs. Davidson. It's been a brief meeting, but a very pleasant one.
Thank you. Judy, would you like me to give you a lift back to the halfway house?
No, I think I really need to walk.
Oh, right, I'll walk with you.
I can't believe this. I thought I was going to end up back in Wentworth. I'd lose the house.
It's wonderful news. Oh, it certainly is.
Judy, you know how difficult things have been since we restricted communication between the officers and women?
Oh, do I ever. Every time I go to the prison, someone has a bitch about it.
Well, I had hoped a social worker would have solved that problem, but unfortunately, Mr. Simmons didn't work out.
Just a second. If you're looking for a social worker, you're barking up the wrong tree.
Social work is mainly common sense, Judy, and you certainly have plenty of that. No, that's not what I had in mind. What I want is a careers officer, someone who can advise the women and find them jobs when they're released.
You mean the sort of work Mrs. Morris did when I was inside?
That's right.
Are you offering me this job?
If you're interested. Unfortunately, the money's not worth talking about, but you would have a semi-official position and freer access to the women.
Hmm. Do I get the keys to the prison too?
Not quite, but you would get an identification card and you wouldn't have to have my permission every time you wanted to come in to see them. I would have to get the department's approval, but I don't think there'd be any problem there.
No, I can't believe this. I mean, 10 minutes ago, I thought I was going to be a resident of Wentworth, and now this!
Are you interested?
You bet I am! Oh, sorry.
Hey, B. Mm. What's a 5-letter word for idiot?
Try drongo.
D, won't fit in.
Write small.
Oh, yeah.
Smith, I want to talk to you.
Did you hear something?
Oh, yeah. It was me. I had baked beans for brekkie.
Smith?
Hey, Maxine.
Yes?
One of the screws is breaking the rules again.
Oh, no. Well, that's what rules are made for, B.
Excuse me.
You don't think this ridiculous strike is going to solve anything? Mrs. Morris resigned because she'd have been fired otherwise. You're fighting the department on this one.
Then you'd better hope we win, hadn't you?
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, I'm glad you're back. We've got a problem, I'm afraid. The women have gone on strike.
Oh, no. Has there been any trouble?
No, it's been very peaceful. They're locked in the rec room. I thought it was better to leave them there rather than get them to their cells.
Of course. What is the problem?
Well, they won't say, but I think it's about Meg Morris leaving. Smith's waiting to talk to you. How is it?
Quiet as a grave. Leave them there, I say. Let's don't get fed up and hungry.
Well, I better go and see what it's all about. Is Mrs. Morris on duty?
Yeah, she just came in.
Excuse me, Governor. The parole board would like to speak with you.
Very well. I'll take it to my office.
Oh, hello, Mr. Nicholson.
Hello, Judy.
Oh, I haven't forgotten to report to you, have I?
No.
I mean, I've been so busy lately, I don't even know what day it is.
No, it's nothing like that. Wouldn't worry me if you were a day too late. I know you wouldn't miss a report intentionally.
No. Well, I've had a terrific day today. My sister Frances dropped the charges. She's on her way back to the States. Then Mrs. Davidson has offered me...
Judy, about the court case. I told you I'd hold back the report until we knew what was happening.
Yeah, I know, and I really appreciate that.
Well, I'm afraid a copy of the police report went through to the board.
But the charges were dropped.
I'm afraid that doesn't make any difference. An assault charge was made against you. The second since you got your parole. The board want to see you tomorrow morning to show cause why your parole license shouldn't be revoked.
Oh, God.
B? Now, what's going on here? What's all this about a strike?
We're staying right where we are until we get what we want.
Well, what's that?
You, of course, Mrs. M.
Me?
I told you wouldn't take this lying down.
I'm very flattered, but I can't withdraw my resignation.
That's not the whole story, though, is it?
What do you mean?
Well, dear Miss Ferguson reckons you would have got the bullet anyway if you hadn't left of your own accord.
Is that what she told you?
Is it true, Mrs. Morris?
It's possible.
It's bloody criminal, that's what it is.
Why do they want to sack you?
I can't discuss it with you, Bea.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Morris, we're sticking our necks out for you.
Yeah. Well, I'm not asking you to. But I am telling you, go back to work before all this gets out of hand.
No way. It's bad enough when they push us around, but when they start pushing a decent screw like you around, it's time to draw the line.
Yeah,
that's right.
And that line has just been well and truly drawn.
Yes, Ted. Certainly. I'll ring you back. Goodbye. Ted Douglas. Obviously, he doesn't know anything about the strike, or I wouldn't have heard the end of it.
Oh, no, I didn't want to notify anyone until I had spoken to you.
Good. Erica Davidson.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Davidson. It's Judy Bryant. Listen, my parole officer just came to see me. I gotta face the board tomorrow. They might revoke my license.
Yes, Judy, I know. The chairman phoned me. They're concerned that you're getting a record of violence. But I wouldn't worry about it if I were you. I explained the situation, and I'm sure they're prepared to listen to your explanation.
Yeah, but this is my future we're talking about.
Yes, but they've asked me to come as a witness, and I'll tell them exactly what I was going to tell the magistrate this morning.
Oh, thanks. There's still no guarantee, is there?
No.
All right. Thanks again, Mrs. Davidson.
I've just been speaking to the women. I'm afraid I'm the cause of the strike.
Yes, I know, but it's hardly your fault. Will they listen to reason?
They seem very determined.
Well, I'll speak to them.
Well, what are we going to do, Bea? They're just going to keep us here till we all die of starvation.
Are you still on about your stomach? You know, it takes approximately 30 to 40 days before you actually snuff it.
Oh, that long? We can't stay cooped up all that time.
No, screws won't let that happen, will they, Bea?
Of course, anyway, this is a labour strike, not a hunger strike. We will go to the dining room as usual. Even if they herd us off to ourselves afterwards, it doesn't get any work done.
Yeah, but suppose they don't open the gate?
We will cross that bridge when we come to it.
All right. I understand you have spoken to Mrs. Morris and she has explained the situation.
Oh, all right, Mrs. Davidson. So the situation has changed. We first decided to go on strike.
It was bad enough when we thought Mrs. Morris was being forced out. But now we know that she was only one step ahead of the firing squad, led, of course, by Miss Ferguson.
This has nothing to do with Miss Ferguson. There is nothing more I can do to meet your demands, so I suggest you go back to work or you will be penalised.
Then it's only fair to warn you, Mrs. Davidson. If Mrs. Morris leaves this prison, so does Miss Ferguson, one way or another.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed.